Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, welcome to my channel, and it's time to do freshest PSVR news in the village, but before I do anything, let me just do this. This is the US code for Home Sweet Home, one of the scariest PSVR games at the moment, very, very good horror game. So whoever won, congratulations, because this game is definitely well worth playing. Such a great atmosphere, they're doing great use of the environment. It will just scare shit out of you. You will shit and even your shit will be scared and make another little shit. That's how scary it is. So congratulations to whoever won, and as always, try to be first to the videos, because from time to time, I do those giveaways, yes. Right, okay, but never mind, let me just stop doing this giveaway now and let's do the freshest PSVR news in the village. And the first game we're gonna start from is Honor and Duty D-Day Open Beta, because it returns. It will be available this weekend starting from 26th of October. So if you missed last beta, or if you played it and enjoyed it, now you can play it and enjoy it even more. There's plenty and plenty of new additions. Developers said there's even a bazooka. They say that apparently men with small penises trying to use the biggest weapons. That's why I will be using this bazooka and even tanks when they available. Honor and Duty D-Day, of course, a very fun multiplayer shooter. They even did Battle Royale mode last time. So everything is refined now, so we see what we're gonna get in this beta. This developer listened to every feedback. He trying to make the game you want, so go get the beta once it drops and play it. Play a lot of it and give any feedback. See what works, see what's not, and definitely everything will be listened to and implemented in the game. So we've got release date for Transpose, a very cool looking puzzle game in which you're gonna be making clones of yourself. Every reality is not seems like real, it's all gonna confuse you, but in a very good way. The developer said it's gonna be 30 levels, which gonna take you about 8 hours, so it's on a bigger side. Of course, this developer did in past excellent Blasters of the Universe. What a cool game that was, so let's expect high quality game. Also, they gonna release the Great Sea next year, which lately got released on Steam and had very, very good reviews, even if it's not a game, but an experience, still good reviews. But Transpose definitely looks good as well, so you'll be able to play this on 6th of November. Now, I don't want like crush anyone's dreams about Beat Saber, but as you remember, lately I've been covering the game in my news videos. I said the placeholder release date is December 28th, which meant the game will come out this year, because it's been December 28th, 2018. And then the game got rated, so I was like, maybe they're gonna release November, maybe December. Well, I've been checking on Amazon every day, because that's the best place to check for leakages of the release dates. If something leaking, then it's probably Amazon. So I'm checking in today, and what am I seeing? That the release date for Beat Saber changed. And now the new placeholder date is 31st of December 2019. And what does that mean? I don't want you to panic, don't panic, stay calm, stay fucking calm, nobody fucking panic. Let's just calm down and maybe this is just for physical release, maybe. Maybe there's gonna be some kind of special physical release, I don't know. Or maybe it's some sort of a mistake, or maybe the worst nightmares happens and the game will release in 2019. Sony lately I noticed trying to release like one big game per month. We've had Persistence, Firewall, Astrobot, next month we're having Tetris Effect. For some reason they're promoting shit out of Tetris. Even though the Resign would seem the better choice, but never mind, I don't know. But whatever. For December, they already announced Borderlands 2, I don't know, maybe they don't want it too cramped. Or maybe, like I said, it's just physical release gonna come next year, or maybe just some sort of mistake, I don't know. But just putting it out there that the placeholder release date for Beat Saber changed to the year of 2019. But don't panic. Anyway, another story, Dark Eclipse. The developers don't ask me anything session on Reddit. They spoke to people, they said, come on, ask some questions, we want to answer them. And people who was there said, yes, we got questions for you. And one of them questions was if there's gonna be any new leaders, any new heroes coming to the game. And yes, there will be, they said, next month you're gonna see new heroes, which you can play as. And of course Dark Eclipse MOBA game, which you can download now for free. So if you like free stuff and didn't download this yet, then definitely give it a go. People who downloaded, enjoyed it, it got missed by like a lot of streamers, like this is not my kind of game at all, I don't know even how to properly play MOBA games, so I just like left it aside, but I want to speak about it and I want to encourage you to download it because it's free, just to check it out and of course have fun playing it. Now, Conrad the Kitten got Halloween update. Yes, this game is still alive. They actually updated the engine to latest Unity engine, which is fundament for future updates because they're gonna improve graphics and stuff like that as well. But anyway, in this Conrad the Kitten update, they giving you like a Halloween themed area when everything is spooky and you still holding your Conrad in your hand and shaking it. Shake the Conrad, stroke it, rub it, rub the Conrad. So this should be available on PlayStation VR now as well. It hit Steam yesterday, it should be now on PSVR. Does anyone play this game? Does anyone bought it? I don't know. I played it, I had it for free, like look after the Conrad for a while, now he's neglected, fending for himself, probably homeless and on drugs. But that's not only game that had PSVR update, because Pirate Flight VR got update as well, which improved the graphics. So this game released like while ago now, like a little game for a too high price it was, now it's on sale I think. And it was like you flying around, collecting some coins and shooting balloons and racing and flying through rings. It's had force blinders and stuff like that, but after that, after listening to reviews, developers said, right, I'm changing it, so it's got like a extreme mode. When there is no blinders, you can do rolls and hoops and anything, and it's kind of like more of a more intense side of gameplay. But still, after that update, the developer said, let me just update it a bit more. So the latest update for the game, which it's there somewhere in the background, gives you the better graphics. It's like low poly graphics, but with real life lightning, which improves the game a lot, because now everything looks just better. And also, I want to ask you, does anyone plays Pirate? And also, I want to ask you, does anyone plays Pirate Flight as well? I don't know. Does you? Are you? Are you playing it? Are you playing this game? Tell me now. And that's it, bye.